Absolutely right, John. And there's one moment in particular from these intimate town halls that stands out. A veteran struggling to pay his medical bills tells Bernie Sanders he's considering suicide. It's just one example of how this new approach to the Sanders campaign is revealing a different side of the candidate.
Vermont, an emotional moment on the trail.
Excuse me. I'm a Navy veteran. I served 20 years. I served in Iraq.
Highlighting a new wrinkle with Bernie Sanders' campaign for president.
And I was supposed to be given health care, free health care for life for being a veteran.
I'm looking at a bill. It says account balance $139,000. How are you going to pay off?
I can't. I'm going to kill myself.
John, stop it. You're not going to kill yourself.
I can't deal with this. I have Huntington's disease. You know how hard that is? You know, you probably don't, do you? I can't drive. I can barely take care of myself.
All right, let's chat later at the end of the meeting, okay?
Thank you.
Okay.
A promise Sanders kept, speaking one-on-one with the veteran afterward. In 2016, the Sanders campaign was centered around large, raucous rallies, backed by thousands of enthusiastic supporters who came to hear what the candidate had to say. In 2020, Sanders has turned the tables. He is the one listening. And in town hall after town hall.
My name is Gwendolyn Emmerich, and I want to address ageism.
His campaign stops have become more personal, his supporters sharing their stories of hardship.
My husband lost his job. Then he became disabled. We have been in the disability process for 2 years. We are a week away from losing our home.
And Sanders takes it all in, a candidate known for his prickly demeanor, offering words of comfort and a promise to make things better.
The drug prices are so high that I have an incident from the military that the military government does not cover my medication. It cost me $900 for 5 pills every month. $900. I served this country. I stood in the war for this country. And I need to know, what are you going to do about it?
For Sanders, hearing these stories has only strengthened his resolve to push for his signature campaign issues, like Medicare for All.
It is hard to hear directly from people about the pain that they are experiencing. There are people that I have talked to have lost children because they could not afford the health care that they needed.
Sanders argues that the growing American economy and thriving stock market don't tell the full story of the struggles across the country. These poignant anecdotes reflect that pain.
When one person stands up and says, I can't afford to go to the doctor, millions of people start nodding their heads because that is the reality facing a whole lot of people in this country. But we don't bring about change unless people stand up, tell the truth.
And keep in mind, Sanders has the ability to spend a lot more time hosting town halls and roundtable discussions like these because he spends no time raising money. Sanders draws almost all of his fundraising from online small dollar donations. Instead of spending his time reaching out to big donors, Sanders can focus all of his energy on the campaign trail.